Hare Krishna. The mind is not just a window, it is also a camera. The mind is something which is inside us and it helps us to integrate the inputs coming from the outside world. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Shrotram chakshuh sparshanam cha rasanam ghranam eva cha adhishthaya manashchayam vishayanupasevate. So in 15.8 he says that 15.9 he says that actually the soul gets a particular kind of body in which it has the senses, it has the various knowledge acquiring senses, the eyes, the ears, the nose, the tongue, the skin, and all these are centered around the mind, just as say the five fingers of the hand are centered around the hand. So the inputs from all these five senses come to the mind. So in that sense, the mind is like our window to the outside world. It's a sophisticated window, similar to what say might be present in a security camera, security center in a big building. There's a big monitor on which inputs from the various CCTV cameras at the entrance of, at each entrance of the building may be coming to this monitor. So the mind is like a window which helps us perceive the outer world. But the mind is not just a window, it is also a camera, that whatever is perceived gets imprinted over there. Just like sometimes, you know, whatever is taken through the CCTV, it's stored as data on the computer. And that's why people can later go back and see, okay, what happened at this time on this day? What happened at this time on this day? They can go back and see. Similarly for us, whatever impressions we take in, they come in, we look at the eyes, we look at something, with our ears, we hear something. So those impressions come inside us and they stay inside us for long. Especially those impressions in which we invest our desires and our emotions, they come very forcefully inside us. And once they are forcefully inside us, they just make our life, they shape our life accordingly. They become propositions for the future. In the previous verse, Krishna has said in 15.8, Shariram yadavapnoti yachapyutkramatishwarah grahitvaitani sanyati vayurgandhani vashayat. That Shariram yadavapnoti, that we get a particular kind of body, yachapyutkramatishwarah, and then we give up that kind of body, and we get this, given this body, we go give up one body and go to another body. How do we do this? Ashayat, based on the kind of conception of life that we have acquired. And this conception of life is stored in the mind. So the impressions of the mind become its future propositions. And those propositions become our actions, and those actions determine our destinations. So by understanding that the mind is like a responsive camera, which will take in inputs and then prompt us to act in particular ways, we can become more cautious about what kind of inputs we take in, and especially what kind of inputs we allow them to register in our consciousness. Especially if we strive to take in devotional inputs, we behold the beautiful darshan of the Lord, we speak about His glories, we seek to be associated with Him, by taking in as many devotional stimuli as possible, then by that we will move closer and closer to Krishna. And as He becomes impressed within us, then those propositions to remember Krishna more, to glorify Krishna more, will rise from within, and they will make our life richer and sweeter, and ultimately they will take us to the supreme destination. Being absorbed in the remembrance of Krishna, we will live in Krishna now, and we will attain Krishna ultimately. Thank you. Hare Krishna.